masters. Okay? First is called samsari. I am suffering. Okay? Sadhana. Understand. I is the problem. I thought is the problem. Millions of possibilities to be converted into one thought. I am witness. Okay, so where you are starting is called Jiva Bhava. I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. Okay. Here there is not even duality, there is a triplicity. Three. What is that? I am there, the world is there, the God is there. Okay? So this is called triplicity, it's not even duality. Now the God is also a concept which you have picked up from childhood. God is like that, God is here, God is there, God will do. God has not come and told you something. You have created so many things about God. Okay? Right? So all these concepts, the primary whole world, you have three concepts: I, world, and God. Okay, in this, all this is included. This is called triplicity. Understood? And please understand, this all your concepts, and concepts are based on thought, and thoughts are based on memory. Okay. Suppose you say, I believe in God. Which God do you believe in? I don't believe in God. Why you don't believe in any God?
God is within me. Why should I believe?
Within me means what?
That is within. I am Brahman.
How change the time. So, the God, the world, everything is a concept. Why the world is a concept? Can you tell me how the world is a concept, Gataji? How the world is a concept?
It keeps changing.
Keeps changing. How the world is a concept?
Because it's not real. It appears. It is not what we actually see. It is in mind. And it doesn't seem same as every time. It doesn't seem same to every person.
Every person you can't judge because you don't know how I see the world. Actually, I don't see the world.
It's subjective, but it appears change.
How world is a concept for you?
It's temporary.
In waking state, this is a different world. Dream state, this is a different world. Deep sleep, this is a different world. Dream world, you're saying, coming and saying, it's a dream world. Waking world has changed in the dream state. Dream world has changed in the deep sleep state. And where is the change? It's a concept, mind. It's a useful concept. I'm not saying it's not useful for your interaction purpose and all. But concept you understand as concept only, no? Okay? So, but what happens is the people take this as concepts as reality.
Yes.
Okay? So, they kill you. If you say, I am not a believer, you will be hanged upside down, okay? Don't tell it to people who are believers. They will pluck your neck, pluck your eyes out and hang you up and down. Okay? So, they make the concepts as real. Okay? They start fighting the wars. People kill each other. We have a concept of everything, no? How a nice person should dress? We have a concept. Okay, how a person, spiritual person has to be there is a concept.
Sir, so in Vedanta philosophy, there is nothing like a temple or where you need to go and worship. That concept is not.
No, see, they are all given for a beginner. Okay? Somebody stuck in the world, you give a place him to unstuck. But unstucking is not a solution, realization is a solution. So, but suddenly first for a primary school kid, you can't say that you are consciousness, you are Brahman. So for him, from what he is stuck, you are given a yatra place, temple. So that it's a gradual
transition.
Suddenly you can't tell. That's how it's done. from that point of view, Vedanta has a requirement. Okay, suddenly, I mean, you cannot teach. That's there. But here you people have come to a jnana class, which is the final. If there is something beyond this, there's nothing. Right? If you are actually not got a solution here, it's a hopeless situation. Beyond that, there's nothing else is there. Okay, not that I don't know. It's final. Okay? So there's a triplicity. Right? You understand my this thing? Clear? This triplicity becomes multiplicity. Triplicity becomes multiplicity, which is based on the variety. And this is actually suffering. Because multiplicity. For example, let's say duality. Due. Two. Okay. You are my friend. I and your friend are different. Actually, that friend is much nicer friend. He's my better friend. He's my best friend or your worst friend. So, why the better friend? Whenever I make a phone call, she receives the phone call. You don't receive. So, she's best friend. Friend itself is duality because multiplicity. Okay, now you have more problem to solve. Earlier only friend and my and friend the problem was there. Mm-hmm. Now friend, good friend, bad friend. Now good friend and bad friend calls. Then whom should I give a priority? All complexity comes into picture. Okay, where there is variety, there is a problem. Okay, variety has to be converted to simplicity. That's what is called sadhana. From multiplicity. Simplicity is the journey, spiritual journey. No, I am a spiritual person, simple. What? He will wear the torn dress. That is nothing to do with simplicity. I am simple. Why? I don't shave my beard. That has nothing to do with simplicity. Conceptually, you have to understand very clearly, multiplicity is not reality. One Brahman is reality. The infinite things you convert into one. Then you have only one thing to deal. You and Brahman, then you remove that you and Brahman also, Brahman only is there. Otherwise you keep on getting into everything you name is. So in Brahman say Saguna Brahma, then this Brahman, that Brahman. You get stuck in the word only language. There's a beautiful word in Sanskrit for this. That Sanskrit beauty I can't tell you. Okay, I'll tell the word, please repeat. Vacha Abharana. It's called Vacha Abharana. Okay? Vacha Abharana word Shankaracharya used many times. Vacha Abharana in English, if you have to translate, Abharana means jewel. Okay, in English, if you have to translate, it is only namesake.
Abharana.
Abharana, Abharana. Not Abharana. 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 Abharana.
Abharana.
Decoration. Okay. Vacha Abharana. So I'll give you the example of Vacha Abharana. Okay. Suresh is a nice man. Okay. See, he comes from all the way from Chennai. How much interest in spirituality? Okay. I'm decorating with words. It's nothing to do with him. See, he is a bank employee. Still, he looks like a IT software guy. Okay? See? Yeah, I mean, even if the age, her hair is white, the color is not. So, you keep on praising the guy. Nothing is there. It's called decorating with the words. Okay? Now, other person start feeling jealous. Guruji is decorating this guy. Okay? So, Guruji is saying, praising this guy. This guy is much very close to enlightenment or he's already enlightened. I am where all stupid guys. 8 years you are coming, 9 years you are coming. Okay? So, we are stupid guys. This is called Vachavarana. And this is the biggest problem I am facing my students. If I look at one student, then the person says, oh, you are looking at that student. That student must be very close to you. Their grace is more flowing through your eyes. See, this student is coming so clearly close to you. Some student sits on my lap, their person is more closer to me. This is called Vachavarana. Vachavarana means through words you decorate the person. Okay, nothing is there. So that's why what's happening is the word Brahman is only one reality. With Vachabharana we are creating multiple realities. You understand? Huh? There's only one reality with Vachabharana. Why did Vachabharana came? Because of the mind. Mind is based on the memory and language. Okay? If you didn't have memory and language, you'll live like a fish in a sea. Always peaceful and silent. Your mind is messed up because of memory, thinking, language. Now, that's not a problem. It's a part of evolution. We don't have to destroy it. We have to correct it. Okay? So you have to understand the word called Vachabharana. Vacha, very important word, okay? So whenever you speak something, how the language can be misused, remember Shekhar. Shekhar is a nice man, coming from all the way from Chennai, very close to enlightenment actually. He is actually almost beyond enlightenment. Okay? See how smart he looks. All these are meaningless decorative words. The Brahman is the only reality. We are using lot of decorative words. Decorative words, okay, Shiva, Ishwara, Narayana, okay, Jiva, all these are words only. Words of decoration for Brahman. Okay. So, you have seen a snake on the neck of Shiva?
Yes.
Huh? Why? Isn't it? What is the snake on the neck of Shiva? The snake on the neck of Shiva, snake is a poisonous thing for all the people. Whereas snake is used as decoration. Snake is not harmful for Shiva. Okay? Right? Your language and words are like poison. They are corrupting your mind. Whatever words you are using, you are actually I got into very big trouble in one of my classes. I told something about one of my student, and other student was sitting there, and that guy got 10 days that guy doesn't talk to me. You are that praising the student. This student doesn't talk to me because other student is close to me. How do I do? These are words I have to use and words you are confusing. In front of Guru yourself, you are doing so much a mess, sir. In life, how are you water doing? Please tell me. You are stuck to the word Vachabharana. Okay? You may not be wearing necklace or but Vachabharana is something which is very, very, oh, such a nice friend of mine. What is nice about it? Skin or taste or what is it? You had some taste of it for a friend or something like that? Nice friend. Use the word. Like ice cream or something like that. What? The words are actually not all, you start making the words as real. They are used for communication purpose. Why are you giving more importance than that? Okay? People are making mess out of words, okay? And without the words, not a single TV channel will run. That politics guy said something, and this guy will say, come back and say something. This guy will come back and say something. All there will be 10 news commentators who will come and comment on that. Nothing is there. Okay? Vachabharana is a very important word. If you don't remember Shiva, Japa, Shakti, I am Brahman, remember the word called Vachabharana. Wherever you are using Vachabharana, please remember. Okay?
But does it mean that like Brahman you say, you mean something else, I mean something else. So it is because of Vachabharana?
Yes.
Understanding is different.
Because of your words, because of your language.
Because of language or understanding?
Language leads to understanding.
Wrong understanding.
Language leads to wrong understanding. That's why...
Brahman is in Sanskrit language. Means to you something...
No, I am saying the whole teaching is to come to a long common understanding through communication. Because the moment I say Brahman, okay, something comes into your mind. So some superhero sitting on with a flying what is it?
Shaktiman.
Something will come to that. Ultimately, the guru and shishya communication is coming to a clarity of understanding. Each of us are speaking on the same understanding, not a guru's understanding, not shishya's understanding, but teaching of Vedanta understood both properly. That is the whole communication. That actually is the grace. Okay, grace is not because coming closer to guru and say that actually smell of the guru's mouth will come to this person. If he is not using the people start thinking that is a grace. Okay. We have got a lot of misunderstanding, I am telling you. Okay.
Direct expert. New variety of Shaktipath.
New variety of Shaktipath. Okay.
But sir, direct experience is the best way of clarity.
No, no, direct experience means, please understand, sitting in front of you, that's a live experience, okay? Then your mind doesn't go somewhere. Even if the mind goes, come back, guru comes and shouts at you and you come back to reality. Otherwise, you cannot drifting. In front of your wife, you can go Europe trip. Okay, mind is Europe trip, eyes are seeing it, her eyes. Okay, ear, mind is somewhere, ears are somewhere, you can do that. But in front of guru, you can't. Guru keeps looking into your eyes and see whether this guy is here or present or absent. If he is not present or absent, he will bring some story or something and make some comment which will come back to reality. That is the importance of this thing. This you can't happen in video recording. Okay. Then guru will keep on looking at eyes. Okay, I will see some eyes are dull. Okay, the moment I say some truth, the truth will actually make the eyes shine. Okay, I keep looking. Actually, my favorite pastime is to look at the eyes of the people and see whether some sparkle is there or not. That's what gives me motivation to sit and talk. I want to see some light in the eyes of people. Actually, they become dull and bright, sleepy, okay, and some drifting. So that I want to bring it some sparkle. So that is the teaching. Guru can see the sparkle in the eyes. Shishya can see sense some meaning in the light. That's the personal interaction is required. It doesn't happen in the video and all those things. That's very important. So there's nothing more. There's nothing else which is actually, I mean, there may be some guru may have some electromagnetic field and all. I don't know about that. Okay, but this is what really happens. Okay, electromagnetic field, energy field and all. I don't know all those things. I need one more about clarity, logic. This is a path of Vedanta. Because we have a lot of misconceptions. No? You have studied so many things, no? Actually, one student came to me. And then he came to me first class, then disappeared from second class. Okay, then I heard, then some other student came inside. See, he came to the first class thinking that he is looking for a guru like Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. The moment Ramakrishna Paramahamsa touched Vivekananda, said Vivekananda got enlightened. So that's why he's not coming. He recognizes that you are not like Ramakrishna. Yeah, I am not like Ramakrishna. He is not like Vivekananda also. So people come with a different type of expectations. Okay? Understand? So the guru-shishya communication happens at clarity because all of this communication is to come to the same understanding page. Others, you have some concept of God, some Brahman. Okay? Guru has something. So ultimately, all of us have to converge to Vedantic understanding and we have to think alike. Multiplicity has to come back to?
Simplicity.
Simplicity has to come to unicity. Okay? You know, another class, I was teaching Bhagavad Gita. One person came, you are teaching Bhagavad Gita. Okay, so yes. Are you grahastha? Yes. Have you children? Yes. What's your name? My name is Narasimha Prabhu. I heard you are, I came to the class, people said Prabhuji is conducting class. Yeah, my name is Prabhu. Some people add G, they have a habit of adding G. Yeah. Who gave you name the Prabhuji? I mean, the Prabhuji is a title, right? Who gave you? My father gave me, my father's name is Prabhu family. He thought somebody has given me a Prabhuji title because a big guy. Okay. So my father gave me, my family name is Prabhu and the people are adding G Prabhuji at Prabhu. And the guy went out. He said, you are a householder, you are children, you are not qualified to teach spirituality. Wow. These are the types of people are there. These are all mental concepts. Okay. All right. So, actually, so far in these 10 classes, you have learned about spirituality, what a monk in 30 years of ashram will not learn. Okay? Because 50 years of my sadhana, I have put you in the 10 classes. Okay? A person with 30 years of monkhood will not learn. I have met so many monks. They will not learn. Okay? The reason is simple. Finally, the clarity has to emerge through a lot of sadhana that I have done. Finally, I am giving it to you in a capsule form which you can digest. Okay? Even if you go and stay in ashram for 30 years, you'll be idiots only. Okay? So all the work for whatever you people have to do work, the hard work I have done. I have made it to simpler for you. Okay? This I tell, give an example. You take a headache is there, no? For headache you take a tablet, right? How much the tablet costs? 5 rupees, 3 rupees. Can you tell me what is the chemical in that? What formula is there? Okay? You don't have to research. There are hundreds of scientists and billions of dollars they have spent the research and effort to come to that conclusion, which you can get in 5 rupees. So actually, 30-40 years of my sadhana, I have converted into some 10 classes and given to you. Okay? Made simplified for you. You don't have to struggle. But if you have to struggle, you have to struggle about 30-40 years and still there is no guarantee that solution will come. So, the whole purpose of sadhana is multiplicity to simplicity. Is it clear? So, how do you convert multiplicity to simplicity? Okay. Multiplicity to simplicity, you are converting everything from multiplicity to duality. Okay. The duality is seer and seen. Okay. Seer and seen duality. Seer is a witness. Okay. At the body level, I am the seer of the world. Multiplicity. At the mind level, I am seeing the sense organs. At the sakshi level, I am seeing the mind. Right? At sakshi level, what you are seeing? The thoughts. Okay? The seer is sakshi, the thoughts are seen. At the mind level, seer is the mind, sense organs are the seen. At the body level, seer are the sense organs and the world is seen. So convert the entire world into two, seer and seen. The multiplicity into seer and seen. Okay? Right? This is spiritual sadhana. Then finally, seer and seen make it one. Okay? So, I'll say from multiplicity to duality of seer, seen. Okay? Realization is unicity. Merge seer and seen. Into this is the sadhana. Okay? So, first you have to learn how to be witness, sakshi. Now, witness of what? Witness of the world you are already witnessing. Okay? Somebody is going on the road, dying in the road, you are not bothered actually. You are not affected. You just go. But some close person to you dies, you will get affected. Okay? Or something happens, somebody shouts at you, you get affected. Why? Now you are no longer the witness.
You have become that.
You identify that. So now you have to understand how to witness the mind so that your mind becomes separate from you. Whatever you witness becomes separate from you. Is it clear? Because witnessed changes, witness doesn't. The witnesser doesn't change. Sakshi. So that's what vipassana is all about. Keep on observing the body. Body keeps on changing. Thoughts keep coming. But I, the observer, doesn't change. That is the key. Are you clear? In vipassana, you have to have I am the witness thought you have to have. Okay? Understand? So also understand, the body changes, the mind changes, the witness doesn't change. The body is limited, but witness you can't say how limited, how big or how small, because I am not able to observe the witness. Okay? Now witness is one or many, witness is only one. So like that, you have to merge the seer and seen into one. That is the final step. So seer and seen can be combined into one. By understanding, seen is nothing but appearance, maya. Okay? It's not making seen disappear. For example, the water, ocean and wave. Okay? So I'm not making the wave stop, disappear. I'm making wave is water. Seer is, seen is?
Seen.
Then what is a wave? wave is vacha varna. For water you are saying a very beautiful wave, big wave, but it is nothing, it changes. So everything in the world is a vacha bharana, namesake. Finally it goes back to reality. It may happen today, tomorrow, yesterday. Reality is Brahman, right? So when I say I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, what is that body, mind and intellect? It is a vacha bharana. The I has never changed. The body changes. So that I am the body is a vacha bharana. For a moment you say vacha bharana, it's okay. No? Moment you say I am a nice person, say okay. But as long as you remember vacha bharana, it's fine. It is not discarding the body. Okay? It is understanding body is nothing but a namesake in Brahman. Like wave is a namesake in water. Okay? So you start feeling, oh, I'm not the body, then I'm something separate. Yeah, you are separate, you are the witness. What you are witnessing is namesake as taken as reality. You understand? So are you the body? If you observe the body, you are separating from the body. But when you are working the body, you become one with the body, right? Otherwise you can't work. If you keep on observing the body, you can't work. You may become then you become namesake, you're taking the body. For a role, that's fine. So then I am the body. Then for the then when you have become the body, you can become the world also. I am the world also. You can okay, right?
While working, we can't witness.
While working, if you witness,
body is moving.
Your attention, if your attention is on the witnessing of the body, what's observing? How will you do work?
Body is working. Witness.
I'll tell you what is the witness. Okay, huh? So what happens is the witness means witness the body and mind. Because by witnessing the body, you will understand the working mechanism of the body and mind. Okay? Then the witnessing becomes deeper, then any work also you can witness. Otherwise what will happen? You're not witnessed at all. Without witnessing, how will you know? So now I witnessed what is pattern on the screen. Now even if I remember here, I'll remember the I can go back to the pattern. Yeah, people in whole of their life, they are not witnessed with the body and mind. They are only watching the other bodies. The girl's body, the boy's body. Mm-hmm. Your body you are not witnessed.
Sir, when we see some sensation of anna, paining, so they say that you have to witness. You don't have to react. Okay. Now I ask you, even if we react, so, even
I am witnessing that reaction also, no?
Why we shouldn't react? Not react means, let the reaction happen. No. Witness that reaction also. Is it the best way, or just we should...
I'll tell the answer for that.
If I say that I shouldn't react, so that is also not witnessing.
No. I'll tell you what is meaning of that. Just hold it, okay? You ask the question, just 2 minutes later. So, is this understood everything? Multiplicity or corrupted duality? Seer and seen. Finally, you have to realize, the seen is nothing but vachavarna. Okay, how to convert the scene into vachabharana into reality, I'll teach you. Okay, how any vachabharana, hey, you look nice, Sudha. How old are you? But still you look like your elder sister to your daughter. Huh? So these are all vachabharana. Okay, somebody gives a vachabharana, then how do you go back to reality? You have to go to reality. Nobody else will go to reality. You have to go to reality. How will you go? Huh? How did you go to reality when I praised you? So you have to understand. So you have to go back to reality anytime. Don't get stuck up in vachabharana anywhere. Okay? You understand. Vachabharana is useful. Right? Once in a while praising your wife or husband is useful. But husband and wife believe that that is reality, that is a problem. Separate out usefulness from the reality. So, this glass is useful. Okay? For drinking. Ultimately, steel actually. One day, it will be just weighing. Wait.
Last class you had said like everything is predefined and everything happens, you know, as a result of another the whole universe. If the whole universe is nitya, then how can something that is nitya can happen out of design?
These two questions are related. Okay, I'll come back to that. Okay. Keep the question. Okay, I'll answer that. But before I get into answering these questions, I want to finish up that samadhi practice.
Sure.
Otherwise, we are getting right. Okay. So now you have come to this. All these 10 classes you have heard, right? Okay. Jivan Mukti or process of liberation. I want to tell you. What do you so far coming to the class, before coming to the class, what is liberation and what is Jivan Mukti, you had idea? How do you become liberated and what idea you had?
No idea.
Huh? It's a magic.
Yeah,
yeah. Right, somebody goes to the forest, somebody sits on top of Himalayas. Okay. Somebody has to meditate only 10,000 years. Whether it's born will be there or not, I don't know. So somebody becomes enlightened because of meditation. Buddha got enlightened because he left his wife at least. Minimum. Okay, sat in a forest. So then many people actually sit, go find a forest and find a tree also, because enlightenment tree is a mandatory requirement. Then to specific type of tree, where Bodhi tree, people tree. Okay, I know a person who actually for him his concept of enlightenment is all rishis sat in a cave. So he left his house and keeps on searching for caves for meditation. Okay. And sits in the cave. In one cave, okay, he sat. It's a dark cave. He sat. Suddenly the stone shook and snake started coming out. The entire cave, that below that seat where he's sitting, so many snakes were there. The whole room became filled with snakes. The serpent, Nagarao. Okay. And this guy got so scared. Now any cave he sees, he'll just avoid. Okay, this actually is coming. People convert anything into a misunderstanding. Okay, that's what is said in Upanishad, is that Ishwara, Lord, is in the cave of the heart. Okay, cave of the heart. Heart is actually called Buddhi. Cave of the heart is Pratim Chidabhasa is the cave of the heart. So without understanding Chidabhasa, you search for cave and meditate. The same person in another situation, okay, went to a cave and sat for meditation. After some time he opened his eyes. There are hundreds of eyes are looking at him like this. The cave is full of the wild animals. These two are sufficient for him to remove the escape away from God. So without understanding, people convert everything into some nuisance. Okay? Are you clear? Then, all enlightenment means you have to go to Himalayas. Have you heard of this? Without going to Himalayas, somebody says, by Raisa Adavadi, he has to visit Himalayas before he can claim that he is a guru or enlightened. Have you seen that? Himalayan is such a brand name. Right? Understand? So, people don't understand. What is this also? See, already all our Puranas, they have told in a language, converted to inner experience, they have told in a language. Himalaya is a mountain. What they say is, in meditative state, you go to the peak of their mind. Okay? He is actually, okay, peak of his career. Means what? He is standing on 21st floor or 30th. That means he has reached the top. When you go to peak of your mind, then they compare it to a mountain called Himalaya. Peak of mountain is what? Peak of mind is what? What is the peak of mind? Can you please tell me? You heard so many times. What is the peak of mind?
Enlightenment.
Sakshi. Sakshi is sitting on top of the mind watching it. Okay? When you become the witness, you are at the peak of the mind. Otherwise, stuck in the mind. Bottom of the mind. Advaita. So Sakshi. Okay? So then that is Sakshi. Then people go to Himalayas thinking that, oh, Mukti means it can't be available in Bangalore. Okay? It has to, you have to go to Himalayas. Then they say Mukti means you have to go to Ashram. Okay? Ashram means where there is no tiredness. Shrama means tiredness. Ashram means not tiredness. Okay? So today's ashram concept was not there earlier. They said Brahmachari ashram, Grahastha ashram, Vanaprastha ashram, Sannyasa ashram. All are ashrams only. So now the moment I say ashram, this one Swamiji with big beard and will come weird, some places will come. Okay? Ashram means where there is no tiredness. Brahmacharya or study becomes tireless when you are meditative. The Brahmacharya, the ashram, they told Brahmacharya. Brahmani charitam mansam means meditation they told. That's called Brahmacharya ashram. Here the students don't have meditation teaching practice. They have become stressed. Okay? Then Grahastha ashrama means husband and wife, together they are following dharma and practicing meditation. That's why Grahastha house becomes ashrama. Now it becomes a shrama because husband and wife both are chasing sex and money, not they are chasing dharma or moksha. It is an understanding level, focus level rather than a physical level. So we have converted everything into physical level. Then sannyasa ashram means, now you are dropping, vanaprastha ashram means I am living in the actually vanaprastha ashrama. Vanaprastha ashrama means near the forest, means away from the city. Literally, you have to take. I have taken a near a forest. Vanaprastha ashram means you have to live in a mountain. Okay, so I am actually 21st floor. So Vanaprastha ashram, the prescribed duties. Vanaprastha ashram, retired life has to be peaceful. You have to teach people. You have to study Vedanta and teach people. That's what exactly I'm wondering what I'm doing. Sannyasa ashram means. Even that is not okay. I don't teach us. I am relaxed by myself. That's called sannyasa. Now everything you have corrupted with our wrong understanding. Okay. Then Kailasa. Shiva is in Kailasa. Shiva is not in Kailasa. Shiva is on top of Kailasa. Kailasa means Kaivalya Lasa. Kaivalya Lasa. Kaivalya Lasa. These words are actually, in Sanskrit, the words are actually double meaning. That's why Sanskrit is a very beautiful language. You can communicate the world and this thing. So they say Kailasa means Kailasa, Kaivalya Lasa, alone is there. Okay? Then Lasa means dance, peaceful. Now tell me, in this room how many people are there?
Only
one. How many people are there in this room? If you look at bodies, 11 bodies. But most of the people, they are in ignorance, they think 11 people are there. Okay? Now, you go on top of mountain. Called Himalaya, which is mind. So now Sakshi alone is there. Okay? Shiva is Sakshi. How many people are there in this room? Sakshi only. The Sakshi in you, Sakshi in me, Sakshi in you is a different Kateni, the witness. Then why don't you understand what's going on in her head? If Sakshi is same, you should understand what is going on in her head. Is there one Sakshi or multiple Sakshis here? One Sakshi is there. Okay, Sakshi is not knowing. Sakshi is throwing light of knowing. It's not knowing. It's throwing light of knowing. In your head, your mind, the light of your... What is there in your mind is showing. What is in your head is thing. But you are the Sakshi. You are the light. You are not the seen. Only one Sakshi is there. And that is Shiva. And that's you. So multiplicity, you have to go to unicity. Nanu.
Nanembudu
Nanalla Ideha Manabuddhi Nanalla Sachidanandatma Shivananunani Shivoham
Shivoham
Shivoham. So you have to again and again go back to Sakshi. When you are doing the work, get fully involved in the work. Then you cannot be Sakshi. I have to do cooking. I'll become Sakshi of cooking. Who will come and do? Shiva will come and do his cooking, is it? You know your husband doesn't do, but at least Shiva will come and do cooking? No. You have to get fully involved in the cooking. When you get involved in the cooking, the duality is gone. I am there, cooking is there, the world is there, gone. Now only cooking is there. Okay. Then after cooking, you come back to, you see how great cook I am. Then you come to Jiva Bhava. Don't come to Jiva Bhava, go back to Sakshi Bhava. Cooking happened, over. I am the Sakshi of the body mind complex. Okay. So Sakshi and Jiva Bhava, you are still interacting with the world. Jiva Bhava, you are doing the work, you are getting involved in the work. Sakshi Bhava, you are observing the work. Then Sakshi, you have to go to Brahma Bhava. Now no Sakshi also. You have to drop Sakshi also. Okay. How do you drop Sakshi? By understanding whatever you see, okay, is Mithya. Mithya means, in the sense, the water wave is nothing but water. You don't have to stop the wave. So all thoughts are nothing but consciousness is the water. So go back to consciousness. Shift your attention to consciousness. Then automatically Sakshyam also goes. Only Brahman remains, which is you. Shiva Shakti has become one. Shakti need not be destroyed. Wave need not be destroyed to find water. So you have to understand wave is water. So any thought comes or any feeling comes, again go back to I am consciousness. Okay. Understand that it's temporary, but I am the eternal. Okay?
Not
here, sir. See, the wave is temporary, but I am eternal. Right? Thought is temporary. So from temporary, you shift your attention to, instead of watching the thought, you shift your attention to changeless.
That Sakshi is changeless. Right?
Sakshi is changeless, but still witnessing the thoughts and the body, the witnessing also you stop. Now go back to, shift your attention to yourself. Then nothing to know, nothing to see, no witness to be done.
Knowing happens. Knowing will happen.
No? There's nothing to know, like a deep sleep.
Nothing to know, but knowing will be there.
Knowing will be there, like deep sleep.
Deep sleep.
In awareness. In deep sleep, you have forgotten yourself. Here you have awareness that I am there. Okay, but there's no object. That's called Brahma Bhava.
Can you say that witness is like I am knowing and deep sleep is knowing? Like that?
I am only. Okay. So, we'll take that. I'll take you through that, right? So, now, you may be under the impression that that person sat for Samadhi. In Samadhi, he got some Jnana. So, I also go to Samadhi. Right? Nobody has got Jnana in Samadhi. Okay? Now, after coming to all these 10 classes, did you understand the process of Atmadjnana? Shravana, Manana, Nididhyasa. Okay? Now, out of this, Atmadnana, according to Vedanta, is Shravana Matrena. Mukti is only because of Shravana. No, I will meditate and get Mukti? No. Meditation is to make your calm your mind so that Shravana becomes sharper. Got it? That is the importance of a guru and Shishya. Shravana, Vedanta tells again and again, repeatedly. Mukti is because of Shravana and Shravana Matrina. Huh? You understand what I'm saying? So now, I told the essence of Vedanta. Why Manana and Nididhyasa is required to make your mind more and more calm?
That you talk about meditation, but understanding is different. Sir. Understanding is to understand.
I'll give you an example, okay? First, let me ask you the question. Why Shravana is important? Is this clear to all of you? Okay, let us say, how many years of meditation you do to recognize that there are three ladies called Miss Jagati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti?
Only Shravana.
Now let us say there are people who have done meditation for 10 years, 12 years. They won't even know who is Miss Jagati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti.
They wouldn't even have heard also.
They wouldn't even heard also. That means they understand their body-mind complex is real and world is real and they live with that illusion. Okay? By meditation you don't get that Jnana. Nobody has got realization because of meditation.
Which one is meditation?
Nididhyasa. Okay? Are you clear, I'm saying? That's why Vedanta says realization can happen only with the Jnana, which is given by a realized guru to Shishya. Okay. So, Brahma Satya Jagan Mithya. World is Mithya. After how many years of meditation you will come to know world is Mithya? So, what happens is that Vedanta teaching, which is comes from Brahman, Narayana himself, is told in a some clarificative way, clear way. Okay, that method of teaching is called Prakriya. The Prakriya is the skill of a guru. Okay. So, for example, Miss Jagati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti. I converted the word, coined the word Miss Jagati, Miss Swapna because you can relate. Miss Jagati, Miss Swapna, Miss Sushupti is not an Upanishad. Upanishad, there's completely Mandukya Upanishad, Mandukya Karika. If you read the entire Mandukya Upanishad, Mandukya Karika, you will not understand this. The entire Mandukya Upanishad, Mandukya Karika, I have converted into one story which you can understand in 1 hour. Okay? So, that is called Jnana. So, Jnana has to be given in a certain way student can understand Prakriya. Okay? When this happens, there's a clarity which is emerges. That is called enlightenment or that's called Mukti. Not after you do meditation. Now, why didn't Shravana Manana Nididhyasa? Okay? Right? Manana means understanding. In Shravana, what happens? The guru, the teaching of Vedanta is told clearly to the Shishya. In a way, he can understand. And terminology also should not be confusion. Okay, for example, I say Brahman, you understand Brahman. The guru and Shishya, they get a clarity of what we are speaking of, the same thing. Then understanding of the teaching of Vedanta is also made clear. That's the best of ability guru can do at that place. Okay. Now Shishya goes home. Suddenly he gets a doubt. Okay. Now the doubt is coming. Guruji told me Brahman is the only reality. I am seeing my wife also. What is it? What about her? She is also Brahman. When you start interacting with the love, you start getting doubt. Okay. In Guru's place is more of an isolated place. So then I think everything appears to be real clear. But when you start interacting with the world, you start getting doubt. Right? Now we please tell me why the doubt came. Why the doubt comes?
Old habits.
Why the doubt comes? Because of your memory. All old habits die hard. Okay? Guruji says, Brahm, God and I are one. How can it be? What a sin it is. Huh? You know, what a blasphemy, no? How can I say I am God? Hmm? So all your fears and concepts will start coming out. In the front of the guru, they were sitting hiding. So when you go, they start coming out. Asanas. Right? So are you God? Yes or no?
Yes,
according
to you, but...
Say.
And
by what process you will get a confidence that you are God? You have an idea that you will go and meditate and you will get a clarity that I am God. No. It has to be clear in Shravana. Okay, no, you may think that, oh, Guru just told this class is meditation, let me go and do 2 hours of meditation. I am doing cooking for 1 hour. Now, next day onwards, husband will do the eat in the hotel. I will do 1 more hour of meditation. I will get, one day I will become God. If Shravana has not given the clarity, meditation will not give you the clarity. You understand? Meditation is only reinforcing what clarity you got in Shravana. Are you getting what I'm saying? You become God, you realize you are God in Shravana only. If that has not happened, after 100 days of meditation also, it will not happen. Got it? Yes or no?
Yes.
Was that your clarity before I started telling about this?
No.
What was your clarity?
Understanding and
through listening. Okay, Manana and Nididhyasa is only reinforcing that. Okay. It is equivalent of saying Shravana is equal to surgery. Manana is Nididhyasa is equal to tablet. If surgery has not happened properly, tablets won't save you. That's the whole point. Okay? So what has to happen in Shravana? Nanu. Nanembudu. Nanalla. Ideha. Manabuddhi. Nanalla. Sachidanandatma. Shivananani. Shivoham. Shivoham. This clarity has to come in the presence of the Guru. If this clarity has not come, I'll go home and get the clarity. It'll not happen. Okay? Then what is manana? Is confusion which comes, you have to clarify, not the subject matter. Okay? Subject matter, the clarity you got. Then while going home, after going home, you get some confusion. That confusion you have to clarify. Okay? There's no new input. Only input which can come to us is to listening. And that alone can lead to jnana. Nothing else. No, he meditated and something, third eye opened inside. Kidney opening, heart opening, third eye opening, will not give additional jnana. Okay, we have some concept that, oh, that guy has, that guy sat for meditation, her third eye opened.
Then how did Buddha get, whom did he listen to?
He studied Vedanta for 12 years. Okay. Only thing is, he tried many methods. How to apply the Vedanta was a problem. Okay, he practiced Samadhi practices, didn't work out. Finally, he practiced one thing called Tapasya, which was a practice taught that days. That Tapasya became a Vipassana. Application was a thing. Okay. Not Jnana. Here, Jnana.
Shravana
leads
to enlightenment, why he was behind application?
Manana and
Nididhyasa. But you said that Nididhyasa doesn't give
him that. I'm telling you what is that. Okay? So, Vedanta, Shravana alone leads to Mukti. Okay? So now what is that Shravana you have to do? Brahma Satya. Means only reality is called Brahman. Jagat Mithya. Mithya means appearance in Brahman. Okay? So, these two things have to come understanding, you have to get a clarity in this 10 days class. Right? That understanding clarity will not come through meditation. And you should be convinced about it. Brahma Satya? Jagat Mithya. How many people got this clarity in this class? Please raise your hands. You didn't get it. It's no problem, I'll cut it on one more batch.
We okay. Don't mind coming anyway.
Yeah.
We shall come.
Yeah, you can come. There's a senior batch anyway. So I'll tell in some other ways. No problem. Okay, Shravana, in this Shravana, please understand, finally you have to understand Brahma Satya, Jagan Mithya, and I am Brahman, Aham Brahmasmi. Okay, then finally you realize the world is there, but the world is myself, which is Brahman. Mithya means equivalent of saying Vachabharana, namesake. The reality is Brahman. I alone is the Brahman. I am alone is the world. I means not the body mind, the conscious. So the body is also Brahman, mind is also Brahman, world is also Brahman, okay? Tree is Brahman, sky is Brahman, everything is I. But the name is Vachabharana. Vachabharana means decoration on Brahman. That clarity has to come. Okay? So, I'll give you another example. A pot is there. Okay? A pot, mud pot. Mud pot is there, mud plate is there, mud cup is there. Right? So, here what is Vachabharana and what is reality? Can you tell me?
Mud
is the reality.
Plate, cup,
water, all are Vachabharana. If you powder all this, it can become mud. Now, when you buy a pot, you are actually buying a mud only, with the name and shape, right? So, the name and shape is Mithya. Name and shape pot is called Mithya. Doesn't mean it doesn't exist. It exists, but mud is the reality. But the beauty here is, mud pot is useful for storing water. Mud is useless. Are you getting what I'm saying? Mud pot is functional. Mud is non-functional. Brahman is non-functional and useless. Okay. But Jiva, which is Vachavarana, is useful. You are a functional reality aspect of Brahman. Got it? You cannot separate out from Brahman. You cannot say body mind is not intellect. Body mind is a functional aspect of Brahman. Are you understanding the difference? Mud pot is very useful for drinking water. But mud is useless for water. Brahman is the most useless thing in the universe.
Without Brahman, nothing can exist.
But Brahman is not available for any transaction. Brahman in the transaction form is called Suresh.
No, for any transaction to exist, that existence itself is Brahman. Without Brahman, no transaction can happen.
The existence itself, existence per se, not in the name and form, is not available for transaction. The name and form is functional aspect of existence. Functioning. Okay? So, when I say I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, doesn't mean that I have to separate out the body, mind and intellect. Body, mind and intellect is vachabharana for me. Okay? So, now finally what it will come to say, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not it. Body is Brahman, mind is Brahman, intellect is Brahman, world is Brahman. That's the reality. Now from multiplicity you come back to unicity. Are you getting what I'm saying? Your problem is you are considering you are only the body. The reality is you are the entire universe. Okay, you are considering I am the body and I am separate from God. You are everything. So when you say I am not the body, your addiction to body is removed. The reality is you are the totality. You means consciousness. Are you getting what I'm saying? So to understand, wave is not water, you don't have to wave, remove the wave. You have to, through jnana, you have to understand, oh, this is water, that's wave water, everything is water. Like that, finally you have to come to understanding that all that is there is Brahman. I am that Brahman. Even I am that Brahman. What I consider as myself as a body mind complex is not reality. Clear? Otherwise you don't start thinking, oh, I am like a bodiless being somewhere, floating around like a ghost somewhere. I am the totality has to come. Okay? Then there is no other. I am separate from you, you are separate from me, not there. So then you will come to understanding that there was never an individual at all. The concept of individual is illusion. For example, in a ocean, a big wave is there, small wave is there. Tell me, where is the boundary line? Where will the wave, small wave stops, where will the big wave starts?
No.
But you say this is a small wave. The mind is putting a boundary for transaction purpose. That's okay. Right? So mind is putting a boundary saying that this is mud pot. The mind is a mud, you can't operate it, use it. For functional purpose is required, for transaction purpose is required, but reality is Brahman. Are you clear? When I say illusion in the sense not there, it's not, I'm not speaking not there, it is there for practical purpose, it is not there in the ultimate purpose, ultimate sense. Okay? That is again Shravana. That clarity has to come. What you are not understood, you have to get a clarity. Are you clear now? The realization means finally coming to an understanding that I am Brahman. I was never an individual. Not that after jnana I became individual. Jnana only removed my ignorance of individuality. I was Brahman all the time. I will be Brahman all the time. There is no other than Brahman. That clarity has to come. Okay? If that clarity didn't come, then what he'll say? Okay, this class is over, let me meditate on that. You go home. So next moment, some doubt comes. How is it possible I am Brahman?